In this video, I want to talk about something kind of special that we can do with an alternating series that we can't do with others. So I said find the partial sum of the first 10 terms. So let's just start writing some terms down. If I plug in 1, I get negative 1 to the first, and then multiply by 1 over 1 squared. So the first term is negative 1. Next term would be positive 1 fourth, then negative 1 ninth, positive 1 16th, negative 1 25th, positive 1 36th, negative 1 49th, positive 1 64th, negative 1 81st, and positive 1 100th. Okay? And those are the first 10 terms. I'm going to add them up on my calculator. So what I get is negative 0.817. Oh, excuse me, 818. If I can round correctly. Okay. And then I ask, how far from the real sum are we? Well, here's the thing about an alternating series, and let's just think about this from a graphical standpoint. So I'm going to count terms. Let me actually change this a little bit. I'm going to count terms along the x-axis, okay, so terms, and value over here. Okay. So the first term, n equals 1, was negative 1. N equals 2, I added 1 fourth, so it was 0.75. I'd subtract 1 ninth. So what happens is, of course, we just keep bouncing, but the bounce gets smaller and smaller as we go. So the true sum is somewhere in the middle. And as you're going along, we're not all of a sudden going to bounce back down or bounce back up or something like that. That's not going to happen. So when we say how far from the real sum are we can actually do what's called an error bound. And the error bound in an alternating series, and again, this is really for alternating series because other series don't have this nice little bounce back and forth. The error bound for an alternating series is simply whatever the next term is. And the reason is, we're not going to bounce past up or down what the next term is. You know, and again, this is a bound. We're not actually saying what the error is. We're saying the error can't possibly be more than blank. So the next term for us would be, you know, 1 over 121. That would be 1 over 11 squared. So we're not going to be more than 1 121st away. This is our error bound. And again, it's just because we can't bounce further than that 1 11th squared away with the next term. Of course, the actual error is less than that, but as I said, this is the bound. So right now, we're within, you know, 1 divided by 121, we're within about 8 thousandths of the actual sum. So this is something that's really nice in alternating series that we can't do with others, as I said, because of this bounce. So that, you know, when they say, how close are we, what's the error? All you would need to do is go to the next term. So on the very first day, when we looked at the series that estimated pi over 4, this is a really nice thing you can do, is to at some point you say, well, how close am I? Like after this many terms, how close am I to pi over 4? Well, you're within 1/13. So you can also then go along and say, well, how close, I mean, 1/13 is 0.076. How close would I need to go to be within 1/100th? And you could actually calculate that. Okay.